Hello darlings, how are you doing today? You're welcome to the God Experience service for Junior Church. I hope you're fine. I hope you're keeping safe.
So what's this topic? It is called faith over fear. Faith over fear. So I know that one time or the other, it was have lost your faith
or something. Okay.
So now,
what is faith?
What is faith? According to Hebrews 11
verse 1, which I believe a lot of you already know, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Okay, so it means then that things that we're expecting God to do, we can as well believe that He has already done those things. That's basically what faith means. You believing that your expectations will come to pass. Not just believing, your belief must be backed up with the Word of God. That is the evidence. Okay, so now, how do we differentiate faith from fear? But before I talk about that, I need you to also understand that faith is not of the head, because so many times what we think about might not align with what God wants for us. That is the reason why your faith has to be from the head and backed up with the Word of God. And mind you, faith is also different from confidence. You can be confident and not confident in the Word of God. So it is important that your faith is backed up with the evidence of the Word of God. For you to get things done in this kingdom, you need to spend the currency of faith. And faith is very, very powerful. Faith works. If you look through the book of Hebrews 11, on and on and on, you will see people who apply their faith and got results from it. So faith works and faith births results. Okay, so however, fear on the other hand, fear is a powerful tool that the devil uses to pull us down as children of God. And mind you, fear is a lie. Fear is a lie. It's an emotion and it's just a figment of our imagination. 85% of the things we fear actually do not happen. That's the reason why you need to overcome your fears by trusting God and having faith in what He has said about you. Fear is just an emotion, it's just an assumption, a premonition, and it's a negative thought. All right, so let's move further down. So how do I activate my faith as a teenager? How do I start to apply my faith? First thing, just like I've said earlier, is for you to look into the Word of God. After you have clarified what you're trusting God for, what is it that you want, then you need to look into the Word of God to know what God's Word says about that matter. I guess this is where a lot of us fail. This is where a lot of people fail. And the reason is because we are lazy. You need not to be lazy. Look into the Word of God. Thank God internet has made things very easy for us today. You can as well search Google. What does God say about academic excellence? So, reel out all the scriptures, write them down, and begin to confess them. That is one sure way of getting results. Another thing is confession. After you have brought out the scriptures that you are trusting God for, you need to put it in your mouth. Why? Because our words have creative ability. And mind you, you're not just speaking natural words. Now you're not speaking God's word. Imagine God, who created the whole universe by the same word. Do you understand? The Word has creative ability. So when you look into the Word of God and you confess the Word of God, things that you are trusting God for will happen to you. I need to warn you, however, it is not everything you ask God for that He will do. He will not do everything for you because some things are not right now. Imagine a child, a two-year-old or three-year-old, asking to drive a car. Imagine that. It's not possible. Because it's not yet time for that child to ride a car. Same thing with our Heavenly Father. He won't give us absolutely everything that we ask for because He has time and seasons for everything in our lives. So He won't give you everything you need for. However, you still need to release your faith because I believe that though you're going to spend, you know, a good number of years on earth. So you need to start exercising that faith. And the more you exercise your faith, you know what, the better you get at it. So start now in exercising your faith. However, while you're exercising your faith, you need to forgive easily. Forgive other people. Don't hold grudges. Ensure that thing you are trusting God for, you are releasing your faith for, will come to pass. And this will help you to build your love muscle. It will help you to build your faith muscle. I want to read a scripture to you from two scriptures, actually. The first one is from Mark 11, 22 to 24. And it says, I assure you, I most solemnly say to you, whosoever says to this mountain, be lifted up and thrown into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart in God's unlimited power that is already established. This God that we serve has unlimited power, okay? But believes that what he says is going to take place. It will be done for him in accordance with God's will. Remember I said, just like a two-year-old child, that's not God's will for that child at that time. So it won't happen. So whatever you say that is in accordance with God's will definitely happen for you. Okay, for this reason, I am telling you, whatever things you ask for in prayer, in accordance with God's will, believe with confident trust that you have received them and they will be given to you. This is from the Amplified Version and it's very straightforward. So believe, speak, and God will do it. Do you understand? The second scripture is from Romans 10 verse 10, and this is very, very important. And it says, for with the heart a man believes. Remember I said that faith is not of the head, it is of the heart. So you have to believe that the things you're expecting God to do for you will surely happen. So it says, with a heart, a person believes in Christ as Savior, resulting in his justification, you know, that is being made righteous, being freed of the guilt of sin and made acceptable to God. And with the mouth, he acknowledges and confesses. So you don't stop at just believing. You don't stop at just bringing out the scripture that you want to stand upon. You need to also confess. And you confess your faith openly, resulting in confirming his salvation. Do you understand? So Romans 10 verse 10 in Amplified Version, it clearly states the process of application of your faith. So when you're trusting God for anything, you know, so many times we need certain things. It could even be clothes. Sometimes you also need to release your faith to pass exams. Mind you must have done your own part by studying hard, or you can bring God into the matter. Search the scripture on academic excellence. Search the Bible. What does the Bible say about academic excellence? And then it says, I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above only and not beneath. Then bring out that word and believe strongly that God will grant you excellence in that examination. Whatsoever it is you are trusting God for, it could be gadgets, whatever it is that is right for you, God will bring it to pass. Some of you are trusting God for admission. This is an opportunity for you to stretch your faith muscle in order to get that admission that you are trusting God for. Some are trusting God for healing. You can also search the scripture for the Bible for scriptures that talk about your healing, and I appropriate them into your life. Speak them into your life, and in no due time you will see those things happen for you. And again, another reason why we need to trust God or have faith is because we are limited as human beings. We have certain phobias, there are certain things we cannot do by our own power. So we need to bring in the power of God to help us through our limitation. Some people have battling with emotional instability. You can look into the Word of God. In fact, Google has made things very easy. Just go there and search out scriptures that talk about whatever it is that you're trusting God for. You know, it could be your IQ as well. Probably you want to increase your IQ. Go into the Bible. There are scriptures that speak to that. In our weaknesses, some people are very jealous, some are envious, some are talkative, some lie a lot. You can look into the scripture, into the Bible for scriptures that speak to these things, begin to confess them, and you will see your life transformed. And now for you to experience growth and greatness, outstanding results and fulfillment in life, you actually need to release your faith, because God will expect you to do things that your natural ability cannot do. Do you understand? This is why you have to go into the Bible, search out scriptures that gives you strength, that stretches you so that you can become a great person, in order for you to overcome the world, yes, to overcome the lies of the devil. These are things, areas in which you can apply your faith, in order for you to breath what God has put on your heart, in order for you to have dominion in life. You need to go into the scripture, into the Bible, to bring out scriptures that talk about this, and then begin to confess and be that these things will happen to you. Okay, I want to share a story with you. I remember my final year in the University of Ibadan, in pharmacy school then. I was thrown into the most difficult department in the whole school. You know, when I saw my name enlisted in that department, I was so, so sad. And what did I do? You know, I went back to my room, I cried my eyes out, and I prayed to God. And immediately, the Holy Spirit just told me to check Philippians 4:13, that I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. I'm equal to any task. And what did I do? I wrote out the scripture. When I resumed my project, I pasted it on my locker. And every morning in my project's lab, I would always confess this. Guess what happened? at the end of the day, I came out top. I was the best in that class. So what worked for me? The Word of God worked for me. Confessing the Word of God as well worked for me. Mind you, these things work. Releasing your faith works at every time. Even in this period of COVID-19, you can also release your faith that this plague will not come near your dwelling. And truly, it won't come near your dwelling because the Word of God is powerful. Another story is the story of the woman with the issue of blood. Remember that woman? You know, she had faith in her heart. She believed that if she could touch the hem of Jesus' garment, she will be made whole. And she was definitely made whole. You can also do the same thing. You can trust God's word. You can trust Him to bring His word to pass in your life. You can put these words in your mouth. And in due time, you will definitely do what He has promised you to do. So what did I say? Faith is a kingdom currency. In conclusion, it is a kingdom currency for you to bring to pass all of the promises, all of your expectations, all of your desires that God has written, things that God has written concerning you. You need to start to exercise your faith muscle. It doesn't matter how old you are. You might be 10, you might be 12, you might be 15, you might be 18. If you are not too young to start to exercise your faith. You are not too young. And mind you, in fact, it even gives you an opportunity to build your faith so that by the time you get to, you know, probably you are a much older person, you will be strong enough to release your faith for bigger things. Do you understand? So please begin to release your faith. Mind you, just like I warned you earlier, you will fail at it sometimes, but God remains faithful. God remains faithful, and He will always bring to pass the things He has promised you to do. So in summary, look into the scripture. What has God said concerning my academics? What has God said concerning the thing I'm trusting Him for? Concerning that healing, concerning that project, concerning even the current situation we are currently in right now. What has God said about it? Bring out those scriptures and confess them. Say them repeatedly till you believe them in your heart, till it becomes your natural confession. And you will see God come through for you. He will definitely come through for you. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much. I hope you learned one thing or the other from this teaching today. God bless you and stay safe. Bye.